so swept away by the performances she must have seen on Friday that she said, man, I got to check this out in person. She went out to the PBR last night. Is that correct?
Yeah, I did. Yeah, I got shout out to Marilyn and Randy. They gave me and my kiddos some tickets. Sorry.
Mm-hmm.
You know what, though? It was one of those things where we went to church before. And the way that my kids were behaving in church, I should have known how it was all going to turn out.
It's a mistake. It was a mistake to take them out to more public.
I should have known. First of all, in church, Philo, at the very end of church, she yells, and it's almost over. The service is almost over. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And they've done really well, mostly. And at the end, Philo, while it's quiet, she yells, Mom, I'm done with Jesus. Like, everybody can hear her. I'm like, you're not done with Jesus. Keep your mouth quiet. And then as the priest walks out, Frankie starts crying and goes, where'd my teacher go? And I was like, okay, let's get out of here. Well, I was already planning on going to the PBR.
Mm-hmm.
And Dane was going to stay home because he had stuff to do. He needed to work on the garage. Well, based on the earlier, the kids and the way they acted in church, uh-huh. I thought maybe it'd be fine, but we get there, and I don't know what it is. My kids are anti-religion or something,
sure.
But they heard this beautiful prayer that they do at the beginning of the PBR thing. I had no idea. I've never been before.
Mm-hmm.
And as they're praying, it's everybody standing, all these cowboys holding their hats over their hearts. So sweet. And Vilo is just screaming her head off. I don't want to see cows. I don't want to see the cows. I'm like, are you serious? It was so embarrassing. And the poor guy, I feel bad for the guy sitting in front of us because I know she was just screaming in his ear the entire time.
So you just buy him a beer and say, sorry, dude.
I should have. I didn't even know. I felt so bad. I'm pretty sure Frankie pulled his wife's hair a couple times.
Oh, no.
I felt so terrible. And you know what's funny? I kept thinking the whole time, I was like, what if someone recognizes me? Like, what?
That would be the worst.
Oh, my gosh. Because me and my kids were an absolute spectacle.
So it's just you and the kids?
Well, so my sister and, so Marilyn and Randy, we had them on air. Yeah. They were for I Do IQ. You remember that? It was them, my sister and her triplets, and then me and the twins.
Oh, boy.
The triplets did great, though. I had the naughty ones. Like, Philo's, like, spitting popcorn down the stairs. It was really embarrassing. It got to a point, like, I was, like, trying to keep it contained. And then towards the end of it, I don't know. I didn't care. I was like, start throwing crap. I don't even care. Just, like, chuck the cup. I don't care. other than that, it was really cool. I got to see our homeboy, Chase.
Is that who you met?
Nance.
Is that who you met Friday? At
yes. Yep. I got to watch him ride, and I felt really cool. I was like, oh my gosh, I've talked to him. I asked that guy if he goes commando.
And what was I didn't hear the answer to that. Does he go commando?
Yes. They don't wear underwear at all, ever.
That's insane. It just feels like,
it is not insane. I tell you what, I saw it firsthand. Them butts are not wearing underwear.
You're looking for lines.
Nelson and Johanna, 6 to 9, and on demand anytime at froggy981.com. You're listening.
Back in. Talk to the audience, right? Hello.
Here we go.
We're in audition.
You make me nervous.
I make me nervous.
Are you messing stuff up or
probably.
What?
Probably.
Okay.
Morning, David.
Good morning. Good morning.
Cindy says, how is everyone? Gary is not in today. Morning, Shannon. Good morning, Geraldine. Kylie.
What did you do?
I thought it was Kyle because the on my screen, a window popped up as I hovered over the name, but it wasn't Kyle. It was Kylie. Mr. Kyle is going to be going out here pretty soon with a door and a team of people, and we're going to be reverse trick-or-treating. That is going to be a, if we're just us girls here talking, that is going to be an S show, I think.
Why?
Because it's the first time we've done it. We don't have the full team here.
We don't have the what?
We don't have the full team here. We don't have Gary here.
Oh, right. Well, you're not going to like this, but...
Go ahead. Go ahead, dog me.
I'm not dogging
Go
you.
Go ahead and dog me.
It's not dogging you.
Here it comes.
It's not... See, you need to see things more from the other perspective.
Countdown to the dog. Three,
no.
Two, one.
I was just saying a lot of times it is Esho and Gary's gone, is it not?
Oh, here it is.
That's what I'm saying. Don't take it as a dog. Take it as a compliment to Gary.
It's not a compliment to Gary. It's
yes,
a dog
it is.
To me.
No, it's yes, it
it's
is.
It's a for sure dog to me.
For me, it's a dog to me too. Then, because it's I'm here too, and I'm saying it's an S show without Gary.
I don't.
It's a dog to everybody. Then,
fine. They're still a dog.
Don't. Why do you see it like that?
Because
see it the opposite.
No one sees it as the opposite. No one hears that as a compliment. There's not one person in the 160
you
people
don't think
I see
Gary
live
would
right
see
now.
It as a compliment.
Of course, Gary would.
I'm just saying you could see it as maybe you just say it.
I cannot believe you.
You cannot believe me? You can't admit that yourself? Can you admit that yourself?
That it's most of the time it's an S show? I don't feel that most of the time it's an S show without him.
Yes, it is.
Oh, see, that's what I mean. That's a dog. That's a triple dog.
That's a triple dog. I'm just saying I'm always worried about what I say. Because there could be a button push that shouldn't be pushed.
As far as I know, I've got the right button.
See, as far as I know, now you just admitted yourself.
Just take it out of program. That's what I know. Program goes to the radio. Audition goes to the cam.
I meant to tell you about this. I won't talk very much about it. But at least Gary could be like this other person I was listening to on the radio the other day.
Who's that?
I'm not telling you
oh,
who.
Okay.
But the whole time, the leader person.
The leader. Sure. Number one.
The board person, the Gary,
uh-huh.
was like, was not feeling well or something. Was like, and they're like, you need to go home. Who's going to do this? Nobody can do this.
Oh, that would. I wouldn't have worked along with that person. Who's going to do this? Like, you're just so high and mighty. Like, just no one can function without you.
Right.
Yeah, oh, but can know. You do this 100%?
I want to know later.
Yeah,
I can do this 100%, Kyle.
100.
You get pretty flustered back there sometimes.
That doesn't mean that I'm not doing it. Just because he's calmer and cooler and more collected. I got dogs coming from every angle.
Yeah. Rough, no, rough. You don't. It's not that bad. First of all, the first one you shouldn't have taken as a dog.
It was a total dog.
No, it was not.
It's a foot long.
Ew, don't say foot long.
My
dog.
Hot dog dog.
I don't know. That made me feel uncomfortable for some reason.
See?
Why are you turning it into food?
Why turn everything into food?
You do?
I do.
Oh.
We're going to be calling some George Strait winners here in a second.
I had an allergic reaction last night.
To what? Ooh.
Listen to this, what happened to me.
I am.
I was so hungry. The kids, they didn't get to bed until like 10:30. So I'm not eating dinner, supper, whatever, until 10:30 at night. I made myself some ramen because I didn't want to ask my poor husband, who's my little chef, to make me anything. Ooh. So I just made myself some ramen. Well, then I threw away the freaking seasoning packet.
Oh, no.
So it's just, and then I tried the noodles without the seasoning. Cannot.
Gross.
Cannot. So then
you
I
just
thought.
Get the sauce, the package out of the trash.
Okay, that's all. So I think I threw it away. I'm not really sure. And then Dane threw away, like, emptied out the kid's diaper trash into the trash.
Yep.
And I'm not proud to admit this, but I was that hungry that I took all the diapers out, put them in a different bag. It was stinky, gross. Did that, trying to find the sauce packet. Still could not find it. It was a lot of work. And so then I said to myself, you know what? I'm going to make my own seasoning.
Yes.
Joanna, who's a bad cook, thinks she's going to make her own seasoning. So I start pouring stuff in there. Well, then I tasted it. Didn't taste soupy enough to me. Well, then I found these little chicken bouillon cubes.
Yep.
I was like, I'll just shave some of this on
there.
So I start shaving it on there, tasting it. I'm like, oh, my gosh, I am a freaking chef.
Yes.
I'm really good at this. And I start, like, licking it, whatever, start eating it. And Dan comes in there. And I was like, Dan, you got to try this. This is really good. I'm, like, really good at this. And he's, like, looking at my hands. My hands are all red and puffy. And he's like, I'm pretty sure you can't have those cubes. I was like, what?
Joanna.
There's milk in those cubes. And my fingers were swollen. Like, it was so funny. I mean, it was not funny.
Sucks.
But
Joanna.
Who would think that a chicken cube would have milk in it?
Yeah, usually those are made for, like, chicken. You use those and make chicken broth or beef broth.
Right. But you know how sad my husband knows foods that I can and can't have more
yeah,
better
you,
than I do.
Than you do. The one with the allergy.
Who would have thought that, though? A chicken cube?
Thank God for him.
I know he walks in here. He's like, "Do you not see your hands?" I was
so
like,
"Did you just take like Benadryl?"
What?
Did you take Benadryl then?
Yeah, I took Benadryl and I went night night. It was nice. Oh. I should take a picture of him. It was so funny.
Oh well.
Bless you, bless you, bless you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
What? What's going on? Who? Why are you saying prayers?
Who's saying prayers? Oh, for you.
Oh,
maybe.
Donald has surgery.
Oh. Donald has surgery.
I'm ready for those tickets, Nelson. Food is spice and life.
She's taking a personal day, Renee.
For Johanna. I had to start. Oh. Donald, I see that. I'm, like, so confused. I accept your new friend request. Do I delete
the
old person?
Kyle, when are these George Strait tickets on sale? Like,
well, we have a pre-sale code.
So, and where do they go to get that? That's the
question.
I think
it's up on our Facebook page.
Okay.
Here's
so
the
that's
thing.
At 10 a.m.
And that starts today?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then they go on sale, if you don't pre-buy, on Friday.
Okay. Because we did a win them before you can buy them weekend.
Correct.
And that's what we're giving away in a moment.
Yes, sir.
Okay. How do I take these off? Go off of this.
Go off of what?
This is captions.
What's the caption? Oh.
Whatever.
On the video.
I don't even care. I'll just leave it on there.
Just touch a little CC on there.
Becca. No, Dane did not try it. I was actually really offended. He's like, go. Well, I say that, but then he ended up making me food after that.
So that you could eat?
Yeah, he's like, I'll just make you something. Like, thank you. But I went to go get the Benadryl, and I come back out, and this guy's already dumped all my noodles out. Didn't even try. He was just like, I'm sure he was scared. I think I put everything bagel seasoning in it. Like, it wasn't.
Trader Joe's?
I was, yes.
Seasoning?
Yeah, yep. It's the best. Uh-huh. It's so good.
We're live right now, facebook.com/froggy981. So we're going to be able to hear some people getting excited about a huge concert. A concert which, you know, I knew it was a big deal, but the more I hear people talk about it, I didn't realize that it was like a life-changing deal. A once-in-a-lifetime concert, according to someone that Johanna's related to. Said that she would feel bad if she knew she missed her only opportunity to see this artist. George Strait,
yeah.
The king of country.
Oh, my sister is excited. So, you know what? I wonder if a lot of people are like her, though.
Uh-huh.
Like, this is a huge bucket list show for her. You know
yeah.
what I mean? Like, she's been wanting to go and see him for so long.
And this is her opportunity. Straight to the Star City. It's happening April 23rd.
Right. I don't want to, like, put any words in anybody's mouth or, like, spread false information because I have no idea. Mm-hmm. I'm kind of stupid with stuff like this. But do you think he's going to tour that much longer? Isn't he kind of getting old?
Well,
is that just me?
Well, like, he's retired, technically.
He's retired multiple times.
That's what I thought. Okay, so.
And he plays, like, these one-off shows. Like, he'll do the Houston Rodeo every once in a while, too.
Like,
really?
I've heard he still plays in Texas.
Yeah.
Because that's where the ranch is, right? Down in Texas.
I imagine him just, like, randomly, like, playing in a bar and just, like, surprising the people. I would do that all the time if I was a celebrity singer.
Oh, a superstar?
A superstar. I would just
yes.
be like, I say that now, but you probably wouldn't.
Right, because then you're just going to be flooded
like,
by people.
Oh, my gosh, this is so annoying.
There's no way that you can get it. You can get in easily, maybe, but getting out, once they find out that it's you, you're going to be swamped, right?
Right, unless you're, like, a total tool and walk in with, like, lots of security.
Well, I've seen people on the cam already say that they are waiting. They're anxiously awaiting to get our phone call this morning. And we have all weekend, correct me if I'm wrong, it's today, right, Kyle, that our pre-sale starts at 10 a.m.
Pre-sale, 10 a.m. Get that pre-sale code. It's up on our Facebook page.
It is, yes.
Also, if you're part of the country club, you're going to get an email with the link and the code as well.
So before you could do that, we had a winning weekend, and now we've got to deliver on that winning weekend, as they say. So let's just get ready. Who's going to tell them they're on the radio? Am I supposed to do that, too?
Sure.
Probably.
You can.
You want me to?
If you're watching on the cam or you're listening on your radio, you hear a phone ring right now. It's time to pick up. It's live radio. We're running a risk.
Yeah, you are.
I know. I'm running a risk. They
I
might not
say
answer.
You press those buttons really well.
They might not answer.
He's pretty good at pushing buttons.
It's the worst.
I mean, like, I'm used to Gary typing in phone numbers. You know? Beep, boop, yeah, beep, boop, beep, boop.
Usually runs out of time.
Oh, yeah, he's like, oh, God. Yeah.
They're not going to answer, are they?
Are you kidding me?
What?
I just can't believe it. If I was waiting for the tickets, don't give them to him. Shred it. Shred it.
Two times is an emergency.
Three times is a psycho stalker.
Three times is a psycho, yes.
It's weird because I hear ringing on your end, but my phone is not doing anything since right. Ashley on the cam.
Oh,
that's
Ashley,
funny.
Oh, no. There's still other people we got to call. I mean, we do have
if
more than one.
If they don't answer, I say we pick someone else.
You want me? Okay.
Your call has...
Pick someone else. She says pick someone else.
I say pick someone else. I mean, this is a lot of calling live on radio.
It's only 7:30.
Last chance. This is our last chance right here. We're gonna try this, and then we're going to get into Cam's keywords after this.
Kyle?
Hey, this is Daniel. With a message on the back.
Nobody wants tickets today.
Gary Nelson and Johanna in the morning.
They wake me up.
And today's
what losers.
Actually, they still win. We've already selected them to win. So if your name is Heather and you didn't just answer your phone, Heather, don't worry. We still have your tickets here. And same for Daniel. Oh, Daniel, we'll give him a call after we get off the show here.
See, in the afternoons, if I call you when I do like a text to win,
mm-hmm. Yeah.
And you don't answer,
you
don't
win.
You don't win. You move on. You got to move on, man. This is locked in. If they gave me a list of people, I would have just gone down the list.
It's a copy of the list of, hey, these are the winners. This is a copy. It's already been submitted.
Right. Where is the keyword?
I would have just called random
just
numbers.
Just says Cam's keyword.
Yeah, I'm looking for it. Hold on.
People should have. Okay. Heather, I'm waiting by my phone.
Is that the 10 break or the 20 break?
Well, I don't know if it was you, Heather.
I just threw it in there.
Oh, I get you. So. Never mind. That's where you had me confused because I didn't
people
see it.
People should have woke up today. I can just DM. Little jokesters. Debra. She's so funny. Oh, man.
Play it right after traffic, I guess. It's self-contained, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It was so cute at the PBR thing. So Frankie wanted to ride the bulls. Okay. Mm-hmm. So he was like, oh, so surprising to me because he's usually the one who hates loud noises. And it was super loud. But Philo was the one crying most of the whole thing. And Frankie loved it and he wanted to ride the bulls. So I tried to keep him from crying. I told him, I was like, well, maybe we can ride a horse some other time. Like some other time, when they're done. I kept saying that to keep him from crying. Mm-hmm. So then he kept asking me, he's like, Mommy, is the horses done? Is the horses done? Like, oh. Waiting for them to be done doing the thing so we can ride them. Terrible.
Is the horses done?
Is the horses done? And then he was dancing.
We
in
just
the
left
middle
a
of
really long voicemail on Daniel's voicemail there.
Oh, for real? Yeah. I hate when people do that because then it takes up all my space.
Uh-huh. Yeah, for sure. I just saw that the phone was still on. So
he'll appreciate it.
So you're just going to hear
us.
And then you calling him a loser.
Did I just say that?
You what? Losers.
It's all right.
I really said that. I don't even recognize what I say. I don't even realize what I say.
They won tickets. They're fine.
All Heathers on the cam should get a consolation prize, says Heather.
We'll give you a shout out.
Right here, right now. Shout out.
Budget friendly consolation prize.
Sylvan, I was just crushed when your first call, right? The first ring.
Oh,
I got an,
Ashley,
I got an Instagram message.
What?
Sylvan, Sylvania. I just was crushed. Your first call, right at the first ring. I got an Instagram notification vibrate in his pocket. So.
Alexis, your horse runs too much. My dad finally sold my horse, so now I don't have a horse anymore.
You don't sound too upset about it.
Well,
when was the last time you saw your horse?
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. Like, I was fine with it because somebody else would probably treat him a lot better. Not treat him better. He just didn't get it ridden. You know, sure. My dad's not going out there and riding him every day.
Do we know how far away this first place is? Is everyone even here to go?
They're supposed to be here about 7:30.
It's about 7:30.
I think it's like 10 minutes away. We'll do that at like 7:50 or something.
I'm tried doing the door. Camera. It's,
I meant to play
it's
this.
Heavy.
Yeah, this is going to be fun.
This is for the for everyone who wasn't just listening to the radio because you're listening to us on the cam here.
I don't have a choice.
Play.
I'll go with you.
I can leave Nelson in here by himself.
Hey, this is Cam Jurgens. If you want to see me and the boys this weekend, here's your chance to win a pair of tickets to the Nebraska game. Today's keyword is sellout.
Enter that keyword at froggy981.com, and you could win tickets to this week's Husker home game with Advanced Medical Imaging and Froggy 98.
Forgot to give the shout out to the Advanced Medical Imaging again when we did Cam's keyword, so just wanted to get that out there.
On the cam, not on the radio?
That was on the radio, too. I played it on the radio first, and then I realized that I didn't play it on the cam. So
are we on the radio?
We're not on the radio. We're on the cam.
What the heck? You need
you
better
mean?
Communication skills.
I literally just said, hey, I'm going to play this for the people on the cam. Because
I didn't hear you.
Yeah.
It's good to see you, too, Christina.
Maybe I'm bad at listening.
Cam sounded just as excited as, like, the Husker season's going, you know? Like... Hey, if you want to come see me and the boys this weekend.
How would he have known? We recorded them all in one spot. Progressively more depressing. That's
what?
Right.
Renee will be in Switzerland the next 2 weeks.
That's pretty fun. Are you going to go down to Denmark?
Oh, gross.
Inside joke.
Gross.
God, it's hot in here.
Is it? I'm dressing up like Madea. I would say don't go in blackface, though, Deborah. That'll get you canceled. Sell out really a good keyword in the BOGO tickets?
Heather, these were written
the BOGO,
a while ago.
Yeah, and the BOGO tickets were, that was just a flash sale. They're not BOGO right now. You had to get in by Friday.
Eric, I'm going to take the Stros on this one. As much as I like the Braves, like to see the Braves, my wife lived in Houston for a couple years, so she's kind of a fan. And we've got some friends in Houston, so. Yeah. Other than that, no ties to Hotland and the Braves. Other than Dane's a fan.
Mm-hmm. That's why I will be rooting for the Braves, because Dane's a fan. And I will not watch one of the games. Won't even see one.
Tomorrow night, baby.
Deborah. Canceled.
Thanks, Becky. It's good to be back, even though I'm about to leave.
Oh, man.
Are you not hot in here?
Yeah, I'm sure I'm hot, but I'm also sweaty because I'm concentrating. So it's easy to mistake that. I think they're here.
All right, I'll leave you by yourself.
No, you don't have to leave me by myself, but oh, he's doing it anyway. Whoa. He gone. So what's going to happen is Kyle has a door. We have a door, and he's going to take the door, and he's going to go to people's houses, people who are already signed up. So if you are not already signed up, then we are not coming to your house today. Okay? So you got to go to froggy981.com if you want to get signed up for the reverse trick-or-treating. It's real easy to do. You just tell us where you live at. It's got to be where you live at, though. So you can't nominate your grandma or whatever. You can, I guess, but you can't.
Well, you won't.
We're not going. It's got to be, yeah, it's got to be your house. So that people know, legal reasons, we got to know where we're going. People have to know that we're coming, kind of. It might be that these people already, this is one of those things that Penthouse Amy doesn't like when I don't know an answer or when Gary would
Google
know an answer.
The press release.
We can't Google this press release. There's no press release.
I'm just kidding.
So we're going to have to do some creative cameraing around here because.
No, I want to go because I want to watch it happen in real life. I feel like it's not going to be the same effect of awkwardness on the camera. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Are you doing this live? Yeah, doll. We do everything live here. We're a real radio station.
Yeah.
We're authentic.
That was a struggle, but yes.
Well, I was going to say all something.
We're authentic.
Christina, I wanted to go so bad, but I had to wake up really early the next day for, not really early, but I needed it. Our goal was to be at the pumpkin patch by 9 a.m., and I just could not go out and drink and then try to do that. I was trying, though. Oh, my gosh!
Thank God he's here just in time.
No.
Gary, no. No. Please.
Don't you talk like that. He don't know what he's talking about. Yeah. Yes. You didn't say any of that to him. To Kyle.
Say what?
Acting all silly about them not going yet.
No, I asked. Oh.
Hi, Gary.
Did you? Yes, Alexis. I know.
This would be better for this now.
Oh, you did see her. You know what? Someone else said that they saw me, but no one. You got what? Guys, come say hi.
Guys, what are we doing?
Oh, God. We're going right into a break here. We got to set up the. I was just going to talk about a little bit of Halloween costume stuff that came in yesterday. And
what's up with this other stuff?
He's leaving now.
Wait a minute.
Are we already in the pause? Is it already paused?
No,
sorry.
No. Oh, God. Hello.
Sylvania said, listen to Nelson's voice.
Screw you.
Screw you. Facebook.com/Froggy981.
Hello. You gotta catch me up. I just joined the show. What'd I miss?
You missed. We called winners for George Strait for our George Strait winning weekend.
Were they excited? What was it?
No one answered.
And I didn't I didn't pre-call them, so it wasn't like they knew they were gonna. Be
your
on
voice
the radio.
Does change. Like, this feels like a different. I've never had this happen before.
I'm just saying, this is like in real time.
I've never, like, just been with you and then had Gary come back.
What's different?
I don't know. He's a different guy. He's more relaxed.
Whatever.
Really?
It's like his voice just gets more chill. Like, when you're not here, it's like, oh.
You know what? I'm going to take a half frightened. Day. Okay. You guys got this for the rest of the day.
What's going on? I see Kyle is still here.
Kyle's leaving right now to go reverse trick-or-treating.
Is the house that we're going to close?
Yeah, I was told within a 10-minute distance.
Okay. Because I just drove in. There's some cars out there. I mean, there's some traffic out there right now.
There's some traffic.
Yeah, a little bit. It actually made me a little nervous to be on the radio. It's weird because when you come into work, like at 5 o'clock in the morning, there's nobody.
Sure.
Right. There's nobody on the streets. You're like, oh, I'm just talking into a microphone. There's nobody listening. Now there's cars everywhere. I'm like, oh my God, they're listening to every word we're saying. Some pressure
Don't
on us.
Don't tell me that. I just pretend nobody listens.
Right. It's much easier that way.
I got to tell you guys, I wasn't sure I was going to make it in today. I got a feeling that I may have, and I know you're going to go a different direction with this, with Halloween Whatever. Costumes or anything. I think I may have cauliflower ear.
Are you serious?
Why
are you acting sad about it? I thought this was your dream.
How do you may yes. have it? Don't you either have it or not have
it? Make it step one of cauliflower ear forming.
Let's see it.
Sensitivity. No, because then there's going to be feedback on the... I didn't know whether or not I was going to get the headphones on because my ears have been so sensitive lately.
God in heaven.
I think that's what's going on with me.
No.
And then I said this morning, I'm sitting there listening to Nelson. His voice sounded different. I was listening at home. I'm like, I've got to sacrifice my ears.
I got to sacrifice my ears.
The innards are hurting listening to the different voice inflections. The outers, I think, will be okay. They're going to have to suffer with these headphones on.
Oh, my gosh. There's no way. You only been to the dojo 3 times last week. It's not that much.
I went Saturday and Sunday. Don't worry about it.
Whoa.
Oh, my wife is grossed out, too. She don't want me to have them. I said, what do you mean? That means I'm tough. Oh, no guy God. Is going to mess with us when I got cauliflower ears.
What woman wants her man to have
not
cauliflower
one.
Ears?
Why can't you just be strong without cauliflower ears?
What if you have combo?
I mean?
What if you have combo, muscles and cauliflower ears? Then there will no way you can get messed with.
I feel like you don't get cauliflower ear from winning. You know what I mean?
Right. Seems like your face is always down on the ground.
Oh, that's true. I didn't think about that.
You're always
it was a rough weekend for me. All right, well, Kyle has left. We thought he was going to leave earlier. I'm concerned that he's not going to be at a house in 9 minutes. Concern one. Concern number two, we've not walked through any of this. We don't have a microphone.
No.
All of this is going to be done with a cell phone.
Uh-huh.
So
a
we
couple
have,
of cell phones.
Right. We've got to get the audio from the house that we're going to and from Kyle and get the video at the same time. None of this has been rehearsed.
Mm-mm. Not one time. I don't even know that it's really been fully talked about one time. So it's not even that there hasn't been a dry run. There hasn't been a written down run right. that would lead up to a dry run.
If you're clueless about what we're talking about, it's called reverse trick-or-treating. Kyle is going to a house now with a, we've got a, like a crew he's gone with, a camera crew mm-hmm. with cell phones. And we're going to knock on somebody's door. They're going to open it. They're going to see a door that we have. They'll have to knock on that door, and then we'll give them prizes. What, Johanna?
I just don't think, you're probably listening right now. I don't think Kyle's very excited to do this, so we'll see how it turns out.
He is not excited about producer jobs, I don't think. He's more excited about part-time management stuff.
Sure.
You know what I mean? Well, he better get excited. Did he wear a costume?
No.
No, there's no costume.
No.
Is he wearing jammies or anything like that?
No.
No.
Just normal Kyle gear.
Yeah, except for he's kind of growing his hair out on his face.
Oh, really?
It looks a little different to me today. I meant to say something to him, but...
And so the person that we're going... The house we're going to, they have no idea that we're coming to their house.
No.
It's going to be a surprise.
No, yeah.
See, that's a surprise to me, because I didn't know whether or not they knew.
I don't think they know.
I mean, they know that they have the potential.
Right. Okay. Hopefully it's not similar to the George Strait phone calls you had. Nobody answers.
That was
not
terrible.
Gonna be good. Imagine if we're not...
It's already been a train wreck today, so...
It was not a train wreck. I already dogged on it. Listen, I dogged on him this morning,
so
and then
dogs.
You dogged on him when you come in.
Yeah.
This poor guy's been taking a lot this morning.
I'm taking some meat today.
Taking a beating. Yeah. A reverse trick-or-treating with Kyle when we come back.
Funny question.
Oh my you God. Want us some pats?
No, I don't need no pats. I'll take the dogs.
Oh, my God. My ears for real are sensitive.
It looks like it. They're swollen.
I know it.
It's gross.
It's not gross. It's not gross. You know it's not.
Yes, I know it
no,
is.
No, you
it's
do
disgusting.
Not know it's gross.
What?
Oh, I
is
did.
Happening?
Heard his voice different. I'm like, I cannot sit at home.
Oh my gosh. Did you do it for me?
Yeah.
Thank you.
I knew. You picked on Nelson last week too, Jamie says.
I know. We're mean.
So Kyle's not excited.
Thought it might be a be- No, he is not.
What? What did he say?
I can't remember. We were both laughing about whatever he said, though. I can't remember exactly what it was. But he did not seem very excited about going.
Kyle?
Yeah. I said I wanted to go with him. I was going to leave Nelson here by himself. I just feel like it's going to be so awkward in person, and I'm not sure if they're going to convey that with the video. There he is. Oh, I like that vest.
Yeah.
I don't know who originally had found them, but there was a couple that, like, the quick story is a couple did a photo shoot with pumpkin heads and ghosts outside of a Taco Bell. A Taco Bell in Lincoln was trying to get a hold of them because they wanted to send all these pictures off to their management. So we contacted that person just seeing if we could share their photos. I have them on for 810.
Are they from Lincoln?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. You're going to have to reset all that because I don't
know. That's fine.
I just saw whoever posted on our page. Kyle, can you hear us?
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Danny, I know I am an oxymoron, but I when people see me out in public, don't you guys feel that way? You want them to say hi to you,
right?
Approachable.
You're not approachable.
Yes, I am.
No, I would say you're probably number two approachable. I put myself number one. Nelson would be number four, probably.
I would say you're last place approachable.
Why?
Because I can see you like being like, don't talk to me.
No way.
Yes.
No.
We're going to let everybody's iPhone in now.
Hey, Kyle, do they know we're coming to their house?
Do you get me?
No, they don't know we're coming to their house.
Perfect.
Is Kenny in the same car as you right now?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, just as he's connecting to audio, I've let him in to the... just connect to audio real quick, Kenny, and then I'm going to take you out of the meeting for a second.
How am I so...
How close are we?
We're here. We're outside.
Oh, you're outside already. Boy, you just picked a close one, didn't you? That's good.
Yep.
That's good. If you ever try to win anything from us like this in the future, the closer you live, the better.
Yes. Well, especially on the first day.
Yeah.
First day, yeah.
Okay. So
he looks more excited now. Kyle, you look more thrilled to do this. See what I'm saying? Doesn't look like he's growing his mustache a little bit?
He looks like Kevin Costner a little bit to me in Yellowstone for some reason. I don't know why.
It's the vest.
It's the vest.
November.
Yeah.
Dane will be so jealous. Don't tell Dane you said that.
Hey, so listen, can you play this out for me? You guys have the door. Who's carrying the door?
Kyle,
he's got the phone.
I was going to hold it.
Oh, okay.
You hold the bucket of candy.
Okay. Maria's going to hold the door.
So Maria's going to, we're going to have the only lady there carry the door.
Wait, what?
Okay, whatever.
It's got the sign on it. It's nice.
When do you want us to go?
We're heading behind the bush right now.
Well, we have, it's 46. I think we're going to come on after this break here. Maybe we'll set it up here, and then we'll play. Let's just see how it goes. How long do you think it's going to take for you to get up there and knock on the door and all that business?
30 seconds.
Okay. We can do it longer. All within one break. It's already 40, so we're just going to go ahead and start it here. Hang on here.
Favorite morning show on the Tracy's Collision Cam.
Every morning.
Just head over to Facebook. Facebook.com/Froggy981.
Time for some reverse trick-or-treating. This is where we come to you, and you trick-or-treat. We got a door. Kyle, our director of marketing, and our, I don't know what you call Kenny.
Our director of digital?
Yeah.
Yeah, director of digital.
Digital director. All are at a location somewhere in Lincoln, and they are about to go to somebody's house. If you're on the Tracy's Collision Cam, you can see, boy, this is terrible. The only lady in the group is the one carrying the door. Gosh.
And it's heavy. I tried picking it up.
Yeah.
It's a heavy door.
We can see Kyle in the lead. Maria is in the middle with a door.
It's a cute little sign we got on there.
Again, what is going to happen is we're going to place this door in front of their door. Kyle is ringing the doorbell now. Kyle, you got to get behind the other door.
Yeah.
Perfect. Perfect. Oh, there's probably a good 5 feet away. Kenny, can you show this shot of the door of the... There we go.
Oh.
They have a ring doorbell.
They have a ring so they can see out front.
Oh, my God. What is this?
And they have no clue we're at their house.
Are you supposed to, ring the ring?
Yeah,
we were ringing the wrong doorbell.
I've never seen...
Why do they still have the other doorbell underneath the ring doorbell?
Right, I've never seen the dual action there.
I don't know how to do it.
Maybe they have a camera and they're looking at us.
Kenny.
Yeah, they want to know why there's strangers in a door on their porch.
Kenny, when they come out.
I don't think I'd answer. It seems like some weird religion group or something.
Kenny, can you show me a shot of our door? Oh, no, wait a minute. They're answering. There we go.
Oh, babe. me.
Hey, wait a minute. Don't knock yet. Can you go up to the...
Don't knock yet. Shut the door. Shut our door.
They open the door.
Oh, God in heaven.
Oh, my God.
This is terrible. I knew it was going to be...
No one is listening.
Wait, did she have the option between candy and...
November
12th.
Also,
whoa.
I'm obligated to tell you that you're live on the radio right now.
Yeah, I see that.
Good morning.
What is happening?
Good morning. Thank you.
Good morning.
This is Lily.
Lily. Oh, youngest radio star.
Is anybody still with us?
Hold on. I got. Let me.
I don't know what's happening.
Of course I do.
Can you hear us?
Yeah. I don't know.
Okay.
You're welcome.
Can you hear us?
More info.
But.
Okay.
Oh my gosh, this is
This is not well.
And this is why we have to do dry runs on this. Guys,
throw up.
We couldn't hear anything. That was a mess.
I couldn't hear any of that?
No, not really.
And you couldn't hear us.
Could you not hear us?
I could hear you guys.
We couldn't.
You just ignored us, huh?
Yeah.
What the heck?
There's a lot going on, guys.
I know. I see that. But not only that, you guys swung the door open the wrong way, I think. It's got to swing the other way.
That was swung correctly.
You think so?
Yeah, because it swung with the handle.
All right,
handle out.
Oh, I suppose so.
I
guess it'd be handle in for your door, wouldn't it?
How was she surprised?
I think the Ring doorbell threw things off.
It did a little bit.
I think she was okay with us not being a religious group.
Oh, good. And can you tell everybody?
Because
nobody could pick up on the fact that she... Oh, there. She's still there. Hi. What's your name?
Olivia.
Hi, Olivia. What's your costume?
I don't have a... mom.
Oh, you're a mom. That's perfect.
Holding
a
baby. Yeah,
that's
perfect.
That was quick.
Wow.
That was great.
Did you even get a baby out
that quickly?
Yeah. It's really believable.
Olivia, what did you get? What trick-or-treating with us? Reverse trick-or-treating. What did you get?
Cerises.
No, that's not true.
I think it's the Dan and Shay.
Yeah, Dan and Shay tickets. Like Reese's.
I thought that you had to pick between the Reese's and the Dan and Shay tickets. Those were the prizes.
Olivia, thank you for answering the door. We appreciate it, and we hope you guys have a great Halloween this weekend, okay?
Thank you.
All right, thank you. We'll see you later. When we come back. They're going to be set up. We have to workshop this a little bit, I think.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We have another house we're going to be visiting with reverse trick-or-treating coming up.
The Tracy's Collision Cam is...
I saw that. Abort.
Yeah. Olivia was on your divorce party thing. I really liked her. She had her baby.
Yes.
Look how tiny that baby is.
She was.
That was who that was?
Yeah. And that was...
I didn't know that.
Look at how tiny that baby is. She had just had that baby.
6 weeks.
When she went with us, though.
Yeah, she had just had the baby.
It was like 9 days or something crazy like that.
So I think, listen, if we can talk about this for a second.
It was only group therapy, yeah.
Everybody else is saying that was actually fun. Awesome.
If you watched it, if you were listening to that, that was terrible.
Oh, if you're listening, I know. Yes, yeah. I know.
not no offense, Kyle.
If you were listening.
Yeah, if you're listening to your radio, that probably was not good to listen to on the radio. I think what we need to do is when they answer the door, I think Kenny's camera's got to be in their face as they answer the door, first of all.
Kenny's camera's got
to
be in the face?
And he's going to have to do verbal. He's going to have to talk.
Well, what do they want? They just need audio better.
Hear me,
audio.
Kenny. Hear me out, Kenny. You're going to say, hi, I'm Kenny from Froggy 98. This is Reverse Trick or Treating. What's your name? That's it.
That's great. Good job.
And then they'll say their name.
This is like when you give us a script, Kenny.
Yes, that's right. This is reverse script
on
you.
This is reverse script, Kenny.
Hi, I'm Kenny from Froggy 98. What's your name?
What's your name?
This is reverse trick-or-treating.
Do you want to practice a couple times, K-Dog?
Can you put the camera in front of Kenny?
Hold on, let me transition.
Turn Kenny
on. We need to see Kenny. Kenny? This is how we're going to get you a girl, too.
Yeah.
How bad I look on here.
You look
great. You do not look bad. No, you look
can't
wonderful.
Look any worse than I do, Kenny.
Hi, I'm Kenny with Froggy 98. This is reverse trick-or-treating. What's your name?
Hi, I'm Kenny. With Froggy 98, this is reverse trick-or-treating. What's your name?
Perfect.
Yay!
There you go. And then you say, knock on the door, and what? I always say win a prize, but it's not a prize.
It's trick-or-treat.
It's time to trick-or-treat.
It's time to trick-or-treat.
It's time to trick-or-treat.
Perfect. Okay.
This is
Now they're going to knock on the door. And when they do that, you got to get close with them so I can see. Could we see the, okay, the person
opening? It needs to be like a close shot, yes.
Oh, that'd be so funny if we could go into school. Actually, just
and then Kyle. Before they stick their hand, in the basket, we need to know when they're doing that. So, like, just hold on for a second.
Do you hear him?
No.
So, before they stick their hand in the basket, they need to know that.
Mm-hmm. I love.
So you have a phone in front of you too, Kyle. Obviously, so we can hear you. Say, oh, we've got some treats for you. Stick your hand in here and see what you win.
Yeah,
see what you get. So you are going to be saying that on the air because they can't hear us.
So that the audio only gets an idea of what's happening.
Okay.
You know what I mean? If you're only listening on the radio, you've got to have the picture painted for you.
Yeah, Olivia is on the cam now. She said, I didn't even have to say trick or treat.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
You guys, come on. Only once a year we're going to do this.
I know.
That's all right.
I'm kidding.
We'll bounce back. We got all week, right?
She don't mess around, man.
Don't mess around.
She's all dog today. She's got...
I was not dogging you. What did I say?
Dogs.
What did I say, though? What did I say?
You said it is usually an S show when Gary's not here. Now, is that a compliment?
Thank you!
Thank you!
Thank you!
You would hear that as a compliment.
That is a compliment.
Okay, but here's the thing is he's acting like I'm just dogging him, but would that not be dogging me as well? You know what I mean?
It doesn't matter.
It's a compliment to Gary.
Friendly fire. Friendly fire.
What do you mean? I'm saying if I'm...
I don't know. I say it's not a... I don't think it's dogging you. It's just a pure dog on him.
Thank you.
But a compliment.
Thank you.
A compliment that today was better than usual, but the dog is that usually it's not very good. And that's him. You know as well as I do, that's him. Because you're constant. You're always the same. What changes?
That's a good point.
What changes? You don't have to take in it. You don't have to take the fall on this.
Listen, though. That's not what I thought in my head. You're taking it somewhere else. No. We can just keep it with Gary compliment. It was just Gary compliment.
No. It's a dog.
Do you want me to make you some more banana bread?
It's sweet and salty.
I'll make you some banana bread.
Don't. Well, you can't win this back now.
And some cookies.
It's an S show now that Nelson doesn't have his professional radio voice. Sylvania is on you, man.
He won't let it die.
The voicing is so funny, though.
I got to hear it.
It's so crazy.
I got to hear it. Can you tell me? Let me hear it, Nelly.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Just pretend like you have to leave and then walk out and then don't leave and see him. Listen, here's one thing, though.
Give it to me.
It's better than other people on radio, in my opinion.
What's that mean?
All right, I'm going to put you in the waiting room again, Kenny, so you'll be back.
What does that mean? I don't even understand what that means.
Some people on radio sound super douchey to me.
You're talking about his radio voice.
Yeah.
That's what you're trying to get at. You're trying to get at what he sounds. You're trying
better.
To get at what he sounds like that's different as he goes radio voice. That's what you're saying.
This is 100% what I'm saying, yes. That is what I'm saying. But it's a compliment, though. I'm saying it's better than most.
You're saying that I slip into a fake voice.
Kind of.
No, I do not.
It's different.
No, what I'm not doing is I'm not reacting, which is what I do most of the time, is react.
Maybe that's it. Oh, that's good. Wow, you're really dissecting this now.
I've done it long enough to know.
Wait, have you though? You didn't know your voice changed until we started bringing it up.
My voice does not change.
Yes,
my voice does not change.
Sylvania. Sylvania says straight up, it changed.
And I don't know why he gets so savage to me. I'm the only one who can get his name right.
He likes Sylvania.
Sylvania likes you.
I think these guys like nicknames, man.
This is the stuff I'm talking about.
What?
You just say these dumb, funny things.
What's that? So neither one of these answered today.
No.
What else did you guys talk about?
We talked about Johanna at the rodeo.
Oh, you went to the rodeo?
I saw our boy. I think I called him Chase Nance. It's Cody Nance. What was his name?
Called him Chase.
I called him Chase for sure. Oops.
Jesus, people. Will not let this die.
Yeah, Benjamin, I probably would sound like a whack attack if I had to do with the controls. That's why I don't do the controls. Like everyone has a phone voice. Oh, that is true. It is kind of like a phone voice.
It's not like a phone voice. That's a dog. If my voice changes, if my voice changes, that's a dig on me as a professional.
No, it doesn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it
is. Yes, it is. Uh-uh. That means I'm not consistent.
Deborah says, "Love Nellie's voice."
Which one?
You're not friends. Deborah's if you don't give each other a hard time.
Ask her which one.
Screw you. Which one?
Yeah. Oh, that's a good point, Deborah. Which voice do you like better?
God, I'm pitting out.
It's cool, man.
It's cool.
Do you want some refresh?
No.
I don't think it's actually a deodorant, though. Because I sprayed it on my armpits one time, and it didn't feel like deodorant.
It didn't?
No. But I guess I don't know. Voice change, puberty, Nelly. LOL.
I had Taco Bell photo shoot at 8:10, trick-or-treating at 8:20. Send us anything at 8:40, but we can... The Taco Bell photo shoot, if we are doing it, like I've already arranged with her, has got to be at 8:10.
I don't even know what it is, so we're following your lead on it big time.
Yeah.
It's just this post, I think, that's about to go... I think it could go viral. I think we're going to get it right before it does, or it's not going to go anywhere.
There's a tease. Following your lead on the whole thing.
But a good tease does not say, or it could not go anywhere. I don't want to hear that part.
Right, it's going to go viral.
It's going to go viral. We've caught it. And we caught it.
There you go.
Oh. You mean the Benjis?
Nelly's more relaxed than Gary is there. He's professional when he hosts. That's true.
He's a professional broadcaster.
Why are you rolling your eyes?
Because.
He doesn't like people critiquing.
You want to try some kombucha?
I do not. That does not sound good at all. It sounds like feet.
Have you ever tried it? Take a little shot of it. Mm-mm. I'll go get you it. Please.
Please don't make me do that.
Please just try it.
Please don't make me.
It's good for your guts.
Three is five. They're going to have to wait outside whatever house they're going to next because I think they probably pull locations that were close.
What?
Kyle.
Yeah, I figure there's going to be time in between the spots, so I had no, I'm just, for 8:20.
Yeah, you did the right thing. You got to allow them time to get to where they're going to go. I'm just saying, if they pick two locations that were really close, they're going to be there. But they're just going to sit in the car and wait.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Deborah. There what? Are... No, what? Go ahead. I'm sorry.
No.
No, I was just replying to her. She wants to get a shirt that says I'm a Nelly fan. There are shirts like that. Team Nelson.
Can you still buy them?
I don't
though?
Know if you can. I don't think so.
This computer foot was feeling slow to me, and so I was thinking that maybe it's my fault that the things are getting slow. When I was in high school, there was this girl who had to sit on a wooden chair because she would shut down all the computers in the building.
What?
Is that
really?
Crazy? That's not true. Swear to you, cross my
that
heart.
That sounds like witchcraft.
Right? And you know, she was kind of witchy.
What's the wooden chair do?
Because it grounded her. There was what something about her that like allowed electricity pass
this
through.
This is a true story.
Yes, it's 100,000% true. Yes, it
100,000.
Is. I'm not lying.
We've never hit 100,000% true.
Can you find her?
How could she even have a cell phone?
You know what's crazy? One time her brother commented... I don't even want to talk about it. He was kind of weird. Her brother was kind of...
He was kind of weird. The girl could shut down electronics, but her brother was weird.
Yes,
he was
but he stalked me a little bit. Yeah.
Okay.
And one time, I hadn't heard from him in years, and then he randomly commented on a video when I first started in radio. And it wasn't a nice comment.
It was mean?
It wasn't mean. It was just like, you've changed.
Oh, you've changed. That's creepy.
Like, that's what I'm saying.
That's creepy.
That's what I'm saying.
You've changed.
I know.
Gary.
Isn't it the best song ever?
Yeah.
Speaking of songs, you know what song is stuck in my head? Is that stupid Willow Smith song.
Caught a vibe. Baby, I know. I showed that to you how long ago. It is such a good song.
It's
stuck
in my head.
Listen, it's a banger.
It is stuck in my head.
It's a banger. Oh my God, she'd have to be a little witchy with that kind of ability. Dude, it's a real thing. There are people who like pass electricity through them. And I'm starting to think I might be one of those people because every time I touch a computer, it feels slow.
That's where that came. Okay, yeah.
That's why I said thought of that. But also maybe I'm just like really impatient. And I think I got that from you.
I'm not impatient.
You know we like swap qualities? I think I took the impatience quality from you.
You think I'm impatient? I don't know that I'm impatient. I want things to be done right.
Yes. I'm not saying that impatient sounds bad. I think that in normal life, you're a patient guy. Like,
okay.
Or like with me personally, you'd be a patient person toward me.
Yes.
But within things with radio and equipment working and stuff like that, that's where the impatience lies. But I think that it, for you, though, it probably stems from being patient for years.
Yeah. Guy can't take any more of it. Now you're bottled like, up, man.
I know. But now I got secondhand impatience. I have no right to be impatient, and I'm impatient.
Right. Yeah.
You still seem the same to me. Silly Johanna. I was like, oh, Janessa. Janessa knows me from when I was a youngster.
You still seem the same to me. Still
oh my
same
gosh, Janessa, how long? We were in elementary school together.
Huh?
I said they are in place when we're ready for them.
I would like to set it up first, so we could probably still do like 8:10. That works.
8:10 for who?
Who are you talking about?
No, I'm saying that Kyle is ready for for our next element.
I thought you were talking about.
I'm sending the link out now for that person so we can set it up and then.
Kyle. Janessa, where are you living now?
Yeah, we're still going to do 8:20 for Kyle.
Yeah.
You don't have to tell the world that, but I'm just curious. That's so crazy. Listen to this. Brandon, my wife let me know that I develop a terrible accent when I'm talking to people of different nationalities. Oh, no. I think that's kind of sweet in a weird way. I know someone would probably say that that's not right, but I think it's kind of, like, nice.
As long as it don't go 100%.
No, but if you're accidentally doing it, like, you're trying to, like, be more...
Somebody said that. I went back and watched some of that. I couldn't hardly stomach it, though.
Oh, my phone.
That Facebook Live we did on Friday.
You could hardly stomach it?
I couldn't hardly stomach it.
Really?
Yeah, the Facebook Live. Because one of the comments said, why does Gary sound like he's country now? Because I was around rodeo people. I sound like country.
Dude, you know what's weird? You could hardly stomach that? Why?
I don't know. Probably when I zoomed in on the bull. You know what I mean?
I thought it was really funny. That was one of our most viewed lives and most liked.
I know.
Like, there was like 7,000 views on it.
What? Are you kidding me?
Like now, yeah.
Get out of here.
I swear to you. Six point something. There's more views on that than our normal lives.
No.
Yes.
That's what she said.
I swear to you. Look it up. Look it up right now. It's 6 point something views. And not only that, it's like 110.
I loved having Lamar there talking to his fans. We got him. Did you tell him what we got Lamar to do?
I didn't know.
Oh, my God.
I figured he watched it, but I guess I should have figured not. He didn't even rewatch. Oh, man. This.
.com/Froggy981.
Reverse trick-or-treating. We have another house we're going to be visiting before the show is up. We've hopefully corrected some mistakes that we made on that first little run there. We have Kenny, who works at the radio station, director of marketing Maria, and Kyle, producer Kyle, all in the frog truck. We had to do some rehearsing with Kenny. I think he has his lines down now, and he was worried that he doesn't look good this morning. He looks good. Now, ladies on the cam wanting him to lighten the video so they can see his face. He's single, by the way. So another reverse trick-or-treating house is coming up. I don't have any idea what this is about, other than I saw a post that we had, Froggy98, on Facebook, something to do with Taco Bell, and that's really all I know. And then you said we're like on the very beginning of this.
Yeah.
The cusp of this going viral. You think that this thing that we're going to talk about and this couple that we're going to have on, that we're getting them before they're famous.
Yes. I think we're getting a scoop.
What is it?
It is a photo shoot that has started to create buzz around the area that was taken outside of a Taco Bell. It's a Halloween-themed photo shoot. And the way that we found it was because someone was looking for these people. Someone that worked at this Taco Bell put out a, hey, oh my God, help me find, you know what I mean? Internet, help me find these people.
So we might be the first of the first to see
it.
Can I say something really quick?
Yeah.
I know it's been doggone Nelson Day.
Oh my God.
I'm just saying, am I allowed to
here
say
it comes.
If I think dog, it's
gonna go ahead and dog on me again.
She's going to give you credit for this booking, I think.
No, this is credit for sure, but I'm prepping. What if it's not, I don't think it's cool.
Oh, I don't. What do you mean you don't think it's cool?
I mean, am I allowed to tell you if I don't think it's viral?
I don't care if you think it's.
Oh, but then not. Okay, you're going to predict whether or not this goes viral.
The virability, as it were.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, go ahead.
You feel, though, strongly it's going to go viral.
This is something that goes viral, yes.
Okay. Okay.
Do you know what I'm excited about with it?
What?
And this is kind of behind the scenes excitement. Is that I've told him I don't know anything about this. Mm-hmm. It's his booking. He's going to be the lead on this. So I get to hear the voice everybody's been talking about.
No.
This is going to be lead voice that he's going
to
have.
I don't have like a lot to offer here. So just don't be.
Well, you didn't even know I was going to come in. So whatever you're going to do is what you're going to do. Whatever you had planned.
I think you got to let him sit where you sit. And
no.
You
that's
swap. A great
no, idea. That's actually, not happening.
Yes,
it's not
let's
happening.
See what people on the camp say.
No, it's not happening. I don't care what people on the camp say. It's not happening.
I think that we should do it.
What?
Nothing.
Why can't you just play along?
Because I don't want to play along.
It's fun.
Do that in the other voice.
I don't have another voice.
Yes, you do. It's
no,
less
I
angry.
Do not. I have
it's
one voice.
Listen, we're going to take a quick break when we come back. When we come back, this, I don't even know how to explain it, the couple that may go viral, some do a Taco Bell, and what's their faces on it? It's like a...
Can't even see their faces.
You can't even see their
covered,
faces. I'm
yeah,
so
covered.
Curious to know what this is.
All right. We will get into it. I think they're going to join the show when we come back.
They're in the waiting room right now.
Okay.
Oh, nice.
We'll talk to them next.
The Tracy's Collision Camp.
Don't let me forget I have an idea. It's not a cool, great one, but I have an idea.
We'll tell you.
About what?
I'll tell you. This is one. Are you okay?
I just have to go.
To the bathroom?
I just got
to
go. Man.
That is.
I don't know what to tell you.
I just don't understand
don't
strong
know
urges.
You.
You know what I mean? Like,
I don't know what to tell you. It's like.
It's like you consistently always are strong urge. Yo, don't make that face.
Oh.
I can't help it. I can guard my face with the microphone so nobody can see my face.
Oh, I can see it from the side view. Okay, this is what I was thinking. I say we do a face your fears.
I like it.
No.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Yes.
No.
That means I would have to face my fear as well.
No.
I would have to touch cotton balls.
Touch cotton balls. It's not same, same.
Oh, you don't understand, though. It's so bad. But face your fears isn't necessarily just gross things. Like, some people are scared of snakes, and then you could put a snake around their neck. But, like, Gary's scared of mice. We'll make him hold a mouse.
A mouse again? Ooh. So I have another mouse in my house? I'm not bringing the old mouse in.
Just bring that one
bring
back.
Bring that one back.
It's a biter, though. I don't want it.
It's a biter. That would be double face your fear. Face your fear of mice and then also of the scary mouse. This is a super scary mouse.
We do ticks.
You would just have to hold ticks.
No.
People get ticks on them all the time.
Before they latched on.
But yeah, we want to let it latch. No. And not only that, people, you act like it's that so much, it's not worse than cotton balls. Or I mean,
ticks are worse than cotton balls.
No, they're not.
Has a cotton ball ever killed somebody?
If you shove it down the mouth.
If there is a razor blade in there.
You don't think
hidden in the cotton ball.
Shove them in the mouth. I love you, Gary.
Let's look at cotton ball chokings versus tick deaths.
No, it, the tick
Lyme disease?
We're not going to let
disease.
It penetrate.
You can't. You said that the mouse wasn't going to bite
Listen,
it, bit Kyle.
I think Face
you
Your Fears would be such a good
penetrate.
Episode. Think about how fun that would be. No. A Face Your Fears. Because this is the thing. You know, it's like what's in the box, but you already are consenting to what's going
to
happen because you're
me.
Facing your fear.
You and I, we haven't talked about this, and that's why I asked what you guys have talked about on the show yet. The conversation that we had with Penthouse Amy. That needs to be brought up.
We didn't talk about it because Johanna
know.
Scared me off of talking about it.
Because, can I be real with you?
Yeah.
Do you want me to be 100?
Go be 100 emoji.
Because I was worried how you were going to approach it. Mm. I wanted Gary
dog.
To be a part of it.
That's what? A dog.
That's a dog. That's
you
another
know,
dog.
But, no, but why?
But don't
That's
you?
Another
why?
Dog.
No, it's not. Because you know why? Because I already sent you text messages about not posting certain things, and you did it anyway. And then we doubled down.
I wasn't gonna talk about that.
You know how he wanted to why he wanted to talk about it? Because he wanted, quote, and I quote, he says, because I want people to go to the Instagram and watch the video.
I wasn't going to talk about the video. That wasn't even going to be a part
exactly.
of it.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. Kate, is it all coming together now? Yeah. I didn't want to talk about it in that way.
Yeah. I want to know what the other two things were that she said to us. That's what I want to talk about.
Ooh,
how her finger was on the button.
I didn't even think about
Friday.
That. I didn't even think
that
about
was
that.
The angle I was going to go with.
Reverse Trick-or-Treating is coming up, Kyle and the gang.
We have a camera crew sitting outside of somebody's house. We're with a door. We're about to take that door to their house and have them trick-or-treat with us. It's coming up. First, though, let me hand this off to Nelly to get us into this next.
So we got Brooke on. Brooke is about to go, I think about to go viral. This is how something goes viral, Brooke, is your photo shoot that you did. Now, for people who don't know, what is this? Is this your boyfriend? Is it your fiance? Who did you do this little cute couple photo shoot with?
So I actually was the photographer, and I asked two of my friends. So two of my friends are dating, and I really wanted to do this photo shoot just for the longest time because I loved that sign outside of Taco Bell on 27th Street.
I haven't seen it. What's the sign say?
So the sign, it says, spooky season is upon us, you beautiful people. And it's under like the Taco Bell logo.
Okay. That's cute.
And I love Taco Bell. So I'm like a frequent drive-through buyer there.
Yeah.
And every time I go past it, I'm like, I just really want to take pictures in front of here with like pumpkin heads or something fall themed. And so on Saturday, we randomly did it. It was kind of just on a whim. And I reached out to my friends and I was like, hey, can you be my models for this? And you don't even have to put makeup on or like do anything because you'll have ghost sheets over your heads and a pumpkin on it. And so they were down to do it. And yeah, we went over there and it was pretty fun.
It's my kind of photo shoot.
So the way we found it is because randomly on the internet, someone was putting a call out to find you guys to figure out what the heck was going on. This might be a weird request, but one of my managers caught some people taking pictures in front of my store's Taco Bell sign, and I absolutely love it. I was wondering if I could get help finding them so they could get a picture out to the Taco. You're going to make the Taco Bell newsletter. That's the first step. That's the first step to going viral, the Taco Bell newsletter.
For real, there's a Taco Bell newsletter.
There's a Taco Bell newsletter.
Wait. Is it just for employees? Like, if you're an employee at Taco Bell, you get a newsletter? That's hilarious.
Well, and you're probably going to get free tacos, aren't you?
Can I like see the pictures?
Yeah. That's the goal.
Yeah.
You should get free tacos.
I hope so, because Taco Bell is, like, my fast food staple. It's truly the only thing I get when I eat fast food, so.
Now, do you believe this is going to go viral? Are you getting that feeling as well?
I mean, you know, that would be awesome if it did. I didn't have, like, when I decided to do this, it was just something I wanted to do for fun. So I had, like, no intention of it going viral or getting as much attention as it already has. But obviously, if it did go viral, that would be super awesome.
Well, and it's like, think about it this way. You're the photographer, so it's your photography company, right, that posted these pictures and everything. Imagine what that could do for your business for something like this to blow up.
Yeah, definitely. And that's honestly why I'm so excited, because it could definitely elevate my business to the next level, which would also be awesome.
And we posted some of the pictures.
Maybe getting free tacos.
We posted some of your pictures with your permission at facebook.com/froggy981. But what's the name of your photography business?
It's Lampkins Creative Photography, and it's that name on all social platforms. So on Facebook, I have a Facebook page, and then I also have an Instagram page if you want to go ahead and check that out. And my website is also Lampkins Creative Photography.
I love the pumpkin
long
heads.
Word as well.
Now, this is a dumb question, but I'm looking at the picture now. Are those, where did you get those pumpkin heads?
So me and my friends actually carved pumpkins on Friday night, and I went to the pumpkin carving session with the intention of making these pumpkin heads specifically for a photo shoot. So
they're really well carved. Like, come carve for me at my house. Terrible.
Oh my gosh. I drew out the carvings, and then my boyfriend helped me cut them out a little bit, but we were a tag team duo, and they turned out pretty well.
That's a real pumpkin on their head.
Yes.
That's crazy.
I was going to ask this because I love it. I want to do family pictures with pumpkin heads, I think. It's perfect. I love the idea of not having to do your makeup and still getting a photo. But aren't they, like, heavy? I feel like it'd be heavy on your head.
Yes. So my friends, when I was taking pictures of them, like, they kept wobbling a little bit.
Yeah.
So, like, I would be asking them, hey, can you guys walk around and, like, Caden, will you spin L around? And
the head flies back, like, as they're spinning.
Yeah. So it wasn't the most convenient thing to do, but So it looks cool, so that's all that matters.
Yeah. Right. So probably like putting it on my 2-year-olds probably not going to work out very well.
Yeah, smaller pumpkins. See, their heads are smaller. Oh, there so we go. Better.
Do little ones. Yeah. I love it.
Well, Brooke, we're going to do our part to help this thing go viral. Best of luck to you, and we'll keep an eye on it. Hopefully, you know, this catches fire and everybody sees it.
Yeah, definitely. Thank you guys for having me on.
You bet. We'll see you later. Thank you, Brooke.
Yep. Have a good day.
All right. Bye-bye. Bye.
Since TV isn't an option for them, join them on.
I wanted to ask her, but I didn't want to put her on the spot. And I know Kenny is listening, too. I wonder if she can do some photos for us.
I was going to ask her that, too.
I couldn't tell if they were real pumpkin heads or not.
I couldn't either because they were carved so well.
Right.
They're carved really well, and the stems are nice.
Stems are nice. How do you stick your head in?
You like, make the hole.
The hole's got to be massive.
It's huge.
Though.
So imagine how big the pumpkins have to be.
I think I'd just cut a big hole out of the back of it so you can just like
just slide it on, but then you go forward and it would fall off.
But what if you did a strap around the back or something?
You were so innovative. Wow, I love
That's
it.
That's like a really in-depth pumpkin head.
Yes, guy. Is he not, though? No? So look at him.
What?
You just can't help it. Your brain Maria is flooding all the
Kenny
time.
Kenny says that's okay.
What it is less stress for him. Because then he doesn't have to face the wrath of Johanna.
Oh, goodness.
I don't want to hear it.
Oh my gosh. Carbonated?
Yeah, a little bit.
Oh.
Hey, guys, we're going to come to you next. So,
it's fermented.
Okay, that sounds
disgusting. Kenny, Kyle, and Maria.
Smell it.
I'll smell it, but I'm not tasting it.
Like, out of this break here. Did you hear me, Nelly?
No, I'm sorry. Tell me again.
No, that's okay. Out of this break, we're going to go to Kenny, Kyle, and Maria.
Oh, it's like gingery,
you just
though.
Take a shot?
No, I don't want a shot of that.
You don't take a shot. I can do that. Don't you worry. Don't you worry.
I don't want to do that.
We are driving up to the house, Maria says. Hey, Kenny.
All right, I'm going to mute you guys real quick. Mute.
Hello.
Hold on, Kenny's phone. Mute. Kyle, mute.
I don't. It's bubbling, Johanna.
Can you guys put the link on here for her pictures? Bubba wants to know.
Hold on.
Do.
Possibly.
Oh, that is why she looked familiar.
Who?
She was our girl.
Yes.
I wanted to say that.
I wanted to that say is, why he looked so familiar.
I knew
she
it was
the driver
her.
For group therapy.
I freaking knew it.
Oh.
Did you think she was familiar too?
No, I knew she. I go, she looks just like the driver from group therapy. I literally thought that in my head. I should have said something.
Can you go ahead and show them on the camera? I like people to see these behind the scenes even.
Like, oh, yeah?
Yeah, may as well.
I'm trying to get a link up. Let me unmute him.
You don't even have to unmute him.
I'm sweating out too, Gary.
To see him.
Has to unmute. Go ahead.
I think I'm bit now. Oh, I am. Sweat.
Oh, yeah. Hi.
It's wet, too.
Hi. Just let us know when you're ready.
Yeah, we got it. Another minute or so.
Kyle, are you growing out your mustache? It looks dark to me. You're letting it go a little bit, huh? I like it.
Yeah.
I wish I had eyebrows.
But I got a little jelly.
What? You saw Dana got a little jelly? Don't let it go.
He looks like a Daner, kind of. Look at how he's got the vest on with the flannel out. That's a Dane.
That's
move.
A Dane look. Yeah. It's a Dane look. It's a little cooler than Dane. Dane's more like.
Dane don't wear them kicks, them shoes he got on, though. Those Chuck.
Yeah,
I was going to say Chuck Norris.
They're just Chucks.
Chuck Norris. That felt right, though, to me. Why?
Maybe Chuck Taylor's
Chuck
if you wanted a full name.
Some
Chucks.
Chuck Norris.
Ooh.
Does Kenny know what he's going to say again?
Yeah, is he still practicing?
Hold on, let me unmute Kenny.
Lane, there wasn't a bowl to get on.
Wait a minute.
We're doing treating. What's your name?
Hi, I'm Kenny from Froggy 98. This is Reverse Trick or Treating. What's your name?
Hi.
Go again. Did he see you doing it?
Oh, why is he cutting out?
Oh, it's cutting out.
week long, we're doing reverse trick-or-treating. Now, if you want us to come to your house, it's not too late. Just go to froggy981.com and sign up. We just need to know where you live, and you need to tell us whether or not you're going to be there when we come. Kyle, producer Kyle, now is leading the team. They're at another house. Kyle can hear us okay.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah, tell Kenny to unmute his phone.
Kenny, you got to unmute his phone, brother.
So we have a camera crew on site. They're walking to another house. What we're going to do here is knock on this person's door, this listener's door. Kenny then is going to introduce himself and say, this is reverse trick-or-treating. He's going to ask the person their name and then say, go trick-or-treating. They're going to have to knock on the door. We have a full-size door we're traveling around town with. Kyle is hidden behind that door with a Halloween basket, and there's some goodies inside. So, Kyle, we need to make sure they say trick-or-treat this time. Okay? We didn't do that last time. Olivia got away with not having to say that.
Mm-hmm. He doesn't respond, so you can't tell if he's here.
Is he being
quiet on purpose?
I don't get
this
it.
This is awkward.
Okay, Kenny, that was Kenny's voice.
That was Kenny. This is awkward. Kenny, yeah. No, it's not. Knock.
It looks dark in there. Hey, Kenny, bang on it. Bang on that glass.
Bang on it.
Hit it a couple of times with the knuckles.
With your head.
Oh, that was still soft.
That was a sweet knock.
The babiest knock I've ever heard.
Maybe he has small hands.
It's dainty. I've never looked at Kenny's hands.
I haven't either.
Kenny, can you show the camera your hands? The size of your hands?
Did you see someone? Is that someone's head or is that Kenny's head? Do you see that? Someone threw that middle hole.
Oh, there they go.
Here we go. Here
everybody
we go.
Be quiet.
Shh.
Hi.
Hi. Hi. This is Kenny with Froggy 98. Oh. We're doing reverse trick-or-treating.
Okay.
What's your name?
Sean Magnuson.
Can you... You want to knock on the door for us?
Go.
Sorry, I just woke up.
No problem.
Go trick or treat.
Open. Knock, knock.
Trick or treat.
Oh, thank you. Candy. Thank you.
What else is in that bucket?
Yeah, what else?
Oh,
he just thought it was candy.
Thank you.
It's currently live on the radio.
Okay.
We should probably tell them first. That.
All right. Hey, yeah, you registered to win our reverse trick-or-treating.
Yeah.
And one of the treats is Deanna Trade tickets.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah,
hang on just a second. We'll get you some more info.
And thanks for answering the door. Appreciate
thank you,
it.
Thank you, yeah.
8 a.m., bunch of strangers yeah. knocking on your door.
I didn't get up until about midnight, so.
Oh. Well, hey. It's one of the nicer things to wake up to. Right?
Absolutely.
Well, thank you. All right. Happy Halloween. Sean. Nice job, Kyle. If you want us to come to your house for some reverse trick-or-treating, go to froggy981.com to sign up.
Froggy 98.
Bye. Come on,
see ya. Yep.
Oh, I get it. It's because... I didn't clock out. So we went from...
Was that a butt punch?
No, we went from... I don't know why it's been doing that lately. And I go to clock out and then it says clock in.
You got to see them, but they're still on. Like, do you want me to kick them out or what do you want me to do with them?
Yeah, we'll see them later. See you later, Kyle. We're done, buddy.
That's not anything. I don't know actually about this or not, but do I clock in? I haven't been, but do I clock in for... Because I'm part-time, do I clock in for remotes?
I don't know.
Depends if you're getting paid the remote.
I got paid.
So probably not.
Nope.
So it's just normal Friday.
Yep. Thank you.
Did he not see the light on? I thought it was like an emergency or something. That was HR. Like, what do we do?
Like coming in to shut it down.
The rabbit bit was Friday.
Yeek. I was going to tell
you. That was run much smoother. That one was.
It was much smoother. I love that he just grabbed the candy things. Like, just like, we just came to his house to give him a reason.
Did we go to the right house, Elizabeth? That's a good question.
Yeah.
I don't know if we did. Did anyone notice he put the tickets back in the bowl? LOL. I guess I didn't notice that.
I did not notice that. HR is handing out pink slips for trick-or-treating.
Great job, everyone, Deborah says.
Oh, my ears really are sensitive.
Why?
Because of jujitsu, for really? Real. Yeah. Oh, you want to hear a funny story? A jujitsu story, real quick.
Yeah, they're looking weird.
Monday, looking Saturday, weird. I jujitsued, and it's open mat. Got one of my gi.
Okay, open mat, so like you can just roll with anyone.
Anybody you want, and there's black belts, brown
I'll
belts,
the smallest
and purple
guy,
belts.
For sure.
Well, I roll with a couple people. First one I roll with is this dude. He was super strong, right?
Mm-hmm.
And we're done. I look down, and there's blood on me. I thought, I made him bleed.
I thought the opposite, and I'm right, aren't I?
I said, I've made him bleed. And I'm looking around, and I don't see no blood nowhere. I say, okay, well, I'm sure it's hidden or something. So I wrestle and I roll with another guy, and we're done. I look down, there's more blood in the same area on me.
You made another guy bleed.
I'm tearing it up today. Tearing it up today. Yeah.
I'm tearing it up.
I tearing up my knee. I lifted up my gi, and there's just, I got these.
Oh, no.
Yeah, it's my own blood. It was my own blood.
Yeah,
I had to take it home and wash it. No,
you
don't
leave
the gi. No, I got to respectful to the dojo. I went home and washed it.
Got to respectful to the dojo.
Yeah. Gary's on the fast track to cauliflower ears. That's what I'm hoping for, Eva.
Oh, my gosh. Please do, actually. Please do get them.
You think I'm joking, but I really do want.
I don't.
Just
think,
like a
I
mild
think,
case of
listen,
it.
Listen, I don't think you're joking, number one, yeah. at all. I definitely think that that's something, some stupid thing that you would think is cool, which is actually disgusting. And
I don't want my
three,
ears. I want to be able to put earbuds in. Like, I don't want them that big. Just a little bit to where people be like, okay, I think that dude knows what he's doing.
Once you go cauliflower ear, you don't go back. Has anybody had cauliflower ear and then it just goes away?
That's what I say. I don't want a bad case
I
of it.
I don't think that that's possible. I think that once you have it, you have it.
You think it gets worse?
It spreads. Think if you're going to keep going down to the dodo, yeah, I do. But I think that you should do it. I hope you get it. I'm going to pray for it.
Thank
for you.
Pray on it.
Yes, I'm going to. I want you to get
will.
It.
I know you will.
Because then I'll make, honestly.
It'd be material when you always leave.
It'd be material. It'd be material. It'd be good material. Then I can make fun of you. Except for, man, you're going to have to wear your headphones more often because I don't want to, like,
you don't think it's a good look on me?
I don't think it's a good look on anybody. And I don't know why you'd want to do that to yourself.
Yeah, I don't know. Just like battle wounds, you know
what
I mean?
No, that's fine. Please.
Because right now I got scars on my toes. But that's not tough looking. I can't kick my shoes off and say, look at my feet.
You do, though. You've literally done that before.
Yes, I have to you guys. Right now, I got Band-Aid again on my big toe.
Oh, do you?
You
want
to see?
Yeah. Just kick them shoes off. Show me.
Oh, man.
I want to see. Deborah, cauliflower ear is nasty looking. You can attempt to get cauliflower ear draped. See, attempt. Hello there, we say it to you all.
Oh, is that NSYNC? Thrush can go to your ears, Jackie.
Oh, yeah, it probably is. Is it yeast in your ear? You probably are more prone.
I probably am. I think I am.
You probably are. Corrective surgery seems to be the only way to correct it. Mm. Are there anybody at the dojo who have it?
Yeah, one guy's getting it.
One guy's getting it?
Yeah.
Is he good?
Yeah.
He's pretty good?
Yeah, he's pretty good.
Pretty
he
good. He's
first,
not good.
He first got it, first time getting it.
How long has he been doing it?
Dojoing? I don't know. Longer than me, quite a bit longer. God, it's hot. Are you guys hot? Is it just me?
It's warm.
I'm like both.
You're sweating. You just told me you're sweating.
I did pit out. Oh. You want to smell it?
Oh, we gotta do that.
It smells good. I finally got it. Hey, did you try that drink?
I haven't yet.
Why can't you just try it for me? Sure. I just want to see what you think.
I think it's going to be disgusting.
Just try it.
I don't want to.
I know you don't.
See that Habsy got canceled?
See? That's not bad. Yeah, I did see it got canceled.
I don't understand it.
Taste more.
I don't want to.
Okay. Yes, you don't mind it, though.
It's like...
You don't mind it? It tastes better than it smells.
It's like vinegary.
Mm-hmm. This one has lemon in it. It's a little different than normal ones.
We are one plus Michelin.
I, right? Isn't it I plus Michelin?
Is it I or L? I and Michelin.
It's I Michelin Volume 2.
I and Michelin. Like Dan and Shay. Dan plus Shay. I and Michelin. I don't know, man. I don't know, man.
Could be a tub of goo.
Or poop.
Mm, like whatever feels right. Feels right. Hey, so can we talk about this quick about tomorrow's I Do IQ? Do we have anybody booked?
Why?
The sponsors wanted to do it. And do we do kid gloves if we do that?
No. I'm a Johanna side almost all the time, but I can't drink that stuff. I know, Carissa. I'm trying to be more I've just been getting into probiotics, but I also read somewhere that kombucha doesn't do anything for you, so I don't know.
I know that I don't like it. But I don't hate it.
I know that I don't like it. There's some I can't drink. This one I don't mind because it's lemony.
Bing dong, long dong.
Deborah, it's some of Johanna's kombucha. Is somebody saying that right? Kombucha?
Kombucha? I don't know. The little one turned 2 Saturday. Oh, no. Sylvania. Well, I'll say this. When they have really bad coughs, the best thing that I ever did was buy those suckers. They have suckers that are like cough syrup suckers or something. I don't know what they are. But I bought those, and those are great. Also, we still suck their boogers out.
With the nose
Frida?
With
those little deals?
No, nose Frida. Have you ever seen those?
Oh, the nose Frida is so good.
All they had was balls when my kids were little.
Okay, well, now they got nose Frida. You stick it. It's a tube, and you stick it in the nose, and the other end, you suck.
No way. Mm-hmm. That's not an improvement. That's not an improvement.
It is
an improvement.
Yes, it is. Oh, it's, my God. It's crazy.
Do you ever get boogers in your mouth?
No, because no. The way it's designed.
But don't you fearful that it may come through?
No, yes. I'm not.
It won't.
I'm not fearful or I wouldn't be able to do it.
I think about that every time I do it. Most of the time I make
Daniel. No way can I do it.
No, would you do it to his nose?
No.
Why?
Why? I do it to your nose. I'm not scared of
that. You would?
You want to do something? There you go. Do something like that. That'll get some people.
What? That? Y'all, you saying that's the fear?
I'd be fearful.
Is that my fear?
To him.
That's not my biggest fear in life. My biggest fear.
Would you do it to his belly button?
Facing your fears.
Do it to his belly button. It ain't going to come through.
That would ruin the nose.
You can't. That's like not even. No.
What are you going to pull out of there? What kind of goo do you think you're going to pull out of my belly button?
Oh, you don't think there's stuff in there?
No, there's not goo. Not something you're going to be able to suck out.
I've smelled the innards of that thing, and there is gross stuff in there for sure. For sure, there is gross stuff in there.
No.
At least some lint.
Oh, there's lint.
That's lint and dead skin. There's no way you're getting the dead skin out every time you think that you are.
What I'm saying is you're not going to get...
Oh, see, look at his face.
What I'm saying is you're not going to get something sucked out of it. Is there like...
If there was a dead skin ball... Ooh, you know what? You
no
might be
dead
right.
Dead skin ball.
Listen, though. Think about this. With you, if you did it with your ear.
Yeah.
I imagine it being waxy on the inside of your belly button.
It's not.
Like, you know that's a thing.
Yeah, it's like there's some type of something.
Dane told me this, and maybe this isn't right, accurate.
Say it.
He told me that if you don't ever shower, like if you just never showered, eventually you would be covered in wax.
Where did he get this fact from?
I can see that.
I don't even want to say how he...
And then what? And then what? then you would never get dirty it. Again because you're covered in wax. Like it's a protective layer of wax.
No, it's just like your skin produces wax. That's why you get wax in your ears. He
but
told me that he knew
on...
a kid. He
no,
knew a kid.
This is... Go ahead. Tell the story. I'm just not.
He told me... This sounds really dumb now saying it out loud. He told me he knew a kid. He said he knew a kid that had waxy arms. Like, he didn't shower for so long that ended up getting wax on his arms. Are you Googling it?
I'm trying to find out if you have
that
wax.
Sounds like a made-up story, man.
But it kind of makes sense. Think about it. You don't. Why do you use your ears make wax?
The Tracy's Collision Cam is live. Search Frog Mornings on YouTube.
Huskers play on Saturday, Purdue. Cam's keyword, be listening to get a 12:30 today. With advanced medical imaging, you get a keyword a day, enter it. at froggy981.com, and you have a chance to win tickets. We'll give them away later this week. Johanna and Kyle are going to be doing the tailgating this weekend, too.
Yeah, we are.
We have a What's in the Box coming up before we get out of here. Sent to us last week. Mm-hmm. We don't know what it is. Kind of. There's some writing on the outside of it, but we don't know if that's what's inside of it. So we'll sing our song, and then we'll open it live on the Tracy's Collision Cam coming up. And I don't feel like we would be who we are unless we address this. I think management probably does not want us to. Probably says, just move forward and act like it never happened. That's mm-hmm. kind of what you do in radio. You just move forward, act like it never happened. We don't do that around here. Talk about things. It's like a family. We talk about things. Things that are right, things that are wrong. Something went wrong on Friday with What's in the Box. Now, you don't know what happened after we got off the air on Friday. I'm going to tell you what happened when we got off the air on Friday. We had a visitor come in the studio. Very seldom does this happen. Usually this goes through the chain of command. Usually the very tip top, Penthouse Amy, if she's not happy with something, will deliver the news to earrings, who then delivers the news to us.
Right.
She cut out the middleman on Friday.
Completely cut him out.
She came in here. It was just me and Johanna Nelson. I don't know where you were.
Going to the bathroom in the women's room downstairs?
Probably. She says, guys, I think we know where the line is. I think we crossed it this morning.
Here's the thing, though. Do we still know where the line is, or was it still just crossed? Blurry. It was so crossed over, like so far, you know, that like it's so that confusing.
We don't have an accurate judge of where the line is.
Yeah.
We just definitely know where too far is.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We, on Friday, I'll just say what it was one time so you know if you weren't listening on Friday. Johanna had her hands in a box. She didn't know what was in it.
Mm-hmm.
It was a deceased rabbit.
So sleepy. It was just a sleepy little bunny.
Who dedicated its life to science. We bought it on a science website.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody could do it. Nobody was in jeopardy of getting bit. There was no disease. There was no... It really... The worst thing about it is Johanna owns a bunny rabbit, mm-hmm. and it was a dead bunny rabbit.
Sure.
It didn't look good. It was not a good look for us. We even said during it, we were regretful, but the integrity of the show
mm-hmm.
says we got to do it. And we did it. And then we get talked to by Penthouse Amy. Here's something you may not know. She almost canceled it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
She almost canceled it when it was happening. She was about to text me and say,
it shut her down.
Shut it down.
Shut it down.
Got to give her credit for not doing it.
Mm-hmm.
Not do we, though.
Oh, my God, yeah.
Well, I don't know. Like,
listen
like,
to Mandy on the camp says it was so crazy, couldn't help but watch it. Yeah, we give her credit for
I
not calling
in. I talked to a guy on Saturday.
I'm saying for myself, my own sake, so I didn't have to touch it.
I talked to a guy on Saturday that was so mad because he was going in to get donuts, and he was rushing to get it, and the lady's trying to, like, upsell him on donuts. Like, just give me the donuts. Because he had to get back in his car.
I gotta get back in the car.
Everybody I talked to in real life said they thought it was funny. And they also said, I don't know. They also said it wasn't, they didn't think it was as bad as a different one we did.
That's where I'm confused. Mm-hmm. So it's okay to put a whole hog head.
And like, not only is it, it's just the head of this hog just chopped off on the back.
You don't have to go that far.
This is what it tells me. Is it can't be a complete body. Can't be a complete dead body. If we do an arm or something.
It's got to be chunks.
Oh, my gosh. She's going to come talk to us again today. She's going to come in here and be like, oh, was I not clear?
That's what I take from that.
Yeah.
It can't be a completely intact dead body. Only
be intact, yeah. Got to be pieces.
Oh, my gosh.
And, you know, it also tells me, listen, if we go that route again, it just can't be. This is not good news for you, whose hands go in the box on Friday.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
It just can't be dead. I think alive is fine.
Right.
No, I think alive is fine.
I think alive is fine.
Depends on what it is.
It obviously. Obviously. Yep. So you're not going to get anything dead on Friday. I guarantee you that.
Nope.
Good thing we got that plexiglass front.
Great. Wonderful. Just remember that was his idea, not mine. Remember to keep that rage that you had for him.
I love that he's more scared of me than he is of you.
Absolutely ridiculous. We bought rob a bank. It's my idea. And then he's like, oh, it's his idea. You had a gun too, man.
Here's the thing. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Gary's going to get it good too. Just accept it.
As long as two.
And you know what?
I understand. Listen, I did the crime. I'm doing the time.
Yes.
But he should have to do. Why do you think I'm an accessory after the fact?
Listen to me. Why do you think that I want it? Punish I don't know, him as well.
Because time heals all wounds, and it'll have been weeks since it happened to you.
You think time heals my wounds? You think for me, Johanna, time heals my wounds?
I don't know, Johanna. You have a special relationship with him. You got a secret friendship with him. We do. You got secret messages.
Yeah, we do.
Yes. Yes.
That's because you were sleepy for a while. We were the only two people asleep. Awake. Who else am I supposed to talk to?
We became good friends. We were better friends when you were sleeping. About 4 months. Try to nudge you. Wake up.
Okay. That's enough. That's enough.
He can do it to me all day long.
You didn't get talked to by Penthouse Amy about almost losing your job over sleeping. I don't want to talk about sleeping. I wasn't asleep.
Well, you're awake now.
You're awake now.
I wasn't asleep then.
Just do what I do. We'd say we are boring. It puts you to sleep.
Well, no. How would he know he was sleeping?
He was sleeping.
It.
He didn't know. How did this turn into this?
I don't know. I don't know.
Yep.
What's in the box? We're going to be opening a package that was delivered to us. We'll do it next.
Nelson is desperately trying to go viral, and you can help. Watch the Tracy's Collision Cam on YouTube. Just search Frog Mornings.
Let's go.
Your smartphone is connected to...
Ah, man. I have to live this life, Slovenia.
Why does everyone think it's because of me?
What?
People, they said this the other day too. It was just because it was Johanna. Like, that's the only reason why everybody was mad.
I have to give you some, I have to be honest with you about something.
Okay. What?
I talked to somebody on Saturday, a different person who also listened to the bit. And she said, I got to talk to you about what happened. I said, okay. She didn't like it, per se, because she said, we made you cry. And I said, no. I said, she was crying before she touched it. She was crying out. Like, I had to explain to her that your tears were from, like, the anxiety of having to put your hands in the box, not because of what you're touching. Mm-hmm. I then told her that you even said, I thumped the thumper. I told her all the jokes. And then it was fine, but I had to go like a step further to explain to her.
I don't. Are you? Did you think that this would upset me? Telling me this? I love this.
No, I'm
I
not
love
saying,
this.
I don't. I'm not saying to explain. Did it upset you?
I love it. I love that. That was what people thought.
And she was a woman, and she was your age.
You guys make me cry all the time. So regardless of any fake tears or not, I think you deserve it, and deserve for people to be upset with you for making me cry.
Well,
also,
what
queen actress?
Did I miss anything with Penthouse Amy's story?
No.
Yes, you did.
What? Oh, did you hit the three times?
No, he didn't.
That's what you missed.
Dang it!
I was gonna bring it up.
We should have.
No, it devolved into crapping all over me.
Yeah, yeah. It took you. I don't even know how we got on that. She probably got us there. Just go back and think about it. See how we got there. Or you can tell us, listening, how do we get on crapping on Nelson on it?
Yeah, it was time heals all wounds. You think that does time heal my wounds?
No.
I said you have a secret friendship.
There
Why
is
do you
where
have
it
a
was.
Secret friendship?
You started it. You started it then. Yep. Okay. He started it. He started it.
No.
Yeah.
No. What I did was I started talking and you threw a ball in my face. We were playing catch. We were playing catch and you threw a ball right in my face.
I'm sorry. I'm better at playing catch. That's not my
That's
problem.
That's not how you play catch. Catch is supposed to be caught and thrown back.
I see them.
That's not better at catch if you hit a guy in the face.
If I can actually catch it, you cannot catch.
You threw an uncatchable ball.
No.
Right at the face.
Again. I apologize. for my extremely good abilities.
That doesn't make you a good player of catch if you throw an uncatchable ball.
Maybe I don't want to be a good player of catch. Maybe I just want to be a standalone amazing athlete. You can't. This is the martyr stuff. You say things to try to hurt me, and then I come back and hurt you worse. And then
I did not try to hurt you.
Well, I wasn't trying to hurt you either.
But you turned around and hurt me. Like, your first reaction is to hurt me.
We do know that that does hurt him, and we do it on purpose. We do.
Nuh-uh.
Thank you.
I do not.
But not to hurt. Not to hurt, though. Just to get... I do it sometimes. Just, I'm curious how you're going to... What's your comeback going to be this time, you know? Like... Dial it back. I'm trying to instigate this Monday, and I'm home with a 6-year-old. Yours, Lavanya.
Oh.
Did you see that? Got extras.
I did see that. Yeah, it's getting hot in here.
This is fun. Oh, yeah, that's not a good eight look.
It's a ball hits you in the face. It's very much catchable.
That's a great point. You guys need to get a long shirt. Oh.
Get a long shirt. No. What?
Oh, man.
I don't want to touch you. Make up. No, do not touch me. I don't need you to touch me. I don't want to touch you.
For the cam.
No. Yes, I already drank your juice.
Why won't you accept it?
Because I don't want to be touched. Just don't touch me. Just don't touch me.
You're not going to let a pretty woman touch you.
I just don't like to be touched. I don't know. It feels like you're... I feel your aura. Yes.
You said that about me last time.
You've got a powerful aura.
Do I? I like that.
But she got a powerful aura.
I got a strong aura, he says.
Is my aura strong?
I don't know.
Who's
I don't
want, aura is stronger?
I don't know that I've ever felt an aura.
Nelson and Johanna are live on the Tracy's Collision Cam. Listen now on Facebook. Facebook.com/Froggy981.
Couple of things before we get to Send Us Anything. Cam's keyword with advanced medical imaging coming up again a couple times today. Be listening for that. Enter it for a chance to win tickets to the game on Saturday with Purdue. More reverse trick-or-treating tomorrow. Go to Froggy981.com. to sign up so we can come to your house. We visited a couple today. You won't know until we arrive. That was evident with the second one. Guy just woke up, said he was up till midnight last night. Kyle, that was the right house, right?
Yeah, that was the right house.
Was he the one that signed up, or was it a wife?
Yeah, it was him.
Him, and yeah. Him.
He's like, and he just took the Reese's. He's like, oh, thank you.
Nice. But when people sign up, they don't know what they're winning either.
Right.
So does it say
right.
We could be knocking on your door.
I mean, he was way too jolly to be woken up to get a piece of Reese's.
How much candy is in the bucket there?
They're only taking what you could grab a handful of candy. It's a full bowl, baby.
Aren't you surprised that they'll only grab one? I do a handful.
Well, you wouldn't grab a handful if you were at somebody else's house, would you?
Yeah.
If they said take as much as you want,
but we don't say that.
No.
We just offer a bowl up to them. So isn't it just polite to take one?
What are you really taking a handful of candy at 8 o'clock in the morning?
You know what?
I don't know. I'm a big boy, so yeah, probably.
Yeah, you just eat different, though.
No, you are sneaky. You act like you aren't up front. You would not just grab a handful. You would take one and pretend like you only took one, and then when no one was looking, you go back in for seconds, thirds.
You buy those Reese's peanut butter cups when I'm not looking.
I would hope that they're going to offer to take the handful. I won't turn away the handful if it's offered.
Well, we could be coming to your house tomorrow. Sign up at froggy981.com. Before we get out of here, another Send Us Anything. Before we open the package, Nelly.
Oh, I almost forgot about it.
Could be a tub of goo or poo or maybe something else that bites. Whatever feels right, you grab yourself a box and then you seal it tight. Send us anything. This is from nuts.com. I assume there's going to be some kind of peanut or...
Well, who's... Do we don't know who sent it.
It doesn't say that. It just says from nuts.com. Open me. Get the inside scoop.
There's like a lot of writing on this box.
Let's see. First, we got
it's from the nuts place, huh?
We've got a packing slip here.
Is it going to be like a funny nuts?
No, it's probably just going to be like...
You know what I mean, though? That's what this show has done to me. I can't just think of a nut as a simple nut.
Rhonda says, thought you might enjoy this sample box. Oh. Now, is Rhonda just a listener? Is Rhonda, does she work for nuts.com?
We got Cam Fam Rhonda.
Yeah, I wonder if
is
that's
that who it is?
I don't know. Cam Fam Rhonda. Was there a last name?
This is the bronze edition box that is going to knock our socks off. 8 of their most tasty premium snacks handpicked to satisfy every craving. And it is basically what I thought. So there's bourbon pecans. There is dried pineapple.
Dried pineapple? Never had
Southern
that.
Southern heat mix.
Oh.
Looks like some roasted almonds. There's a lot of stuff in here. Like trail mix stuff, too. So dried apricots?
Ooh, that's what I like, the dried fruit.
There's a lot of dried fruit in here. Dried mango.
Those not are my sugar. Favorite. Not sugared?
It doesn't look to be sugared. Mm.
you can
sesame
have all
sticks and then some cashews. So from Rhonda, it's a sample box from nuts.com.
Thank you, Rhonda. That's today. Send us anything. Have a great rest of the day. We'll see you tomorrow morning for I Do IQ with Sweet Events. A bunch of music is coming your way next.
Faces for radio, voices for newspaper. Gary and Nelson.
Excited about the Braves going to the World Series. He cried. He made us all sit together as a family.
Cry. That's a break. Did he really cry, or are you making that up?
Yeah, he cried.
He really cried.
You have no idea. He's so excited. Bye. I love you all. I'm just